Here's a fun little experiment where I tried to take the basic concept of Korean-style short ribs, but swap out all of the traditional flavorings for totally different ones. Specifically, I'm using Caribbean flavors, of which I am a huge fan. But of course, first it starts with the beef. These are flanken-style short ribs, which means they're cut across the bone, generally sold about this thick in the States, twice as thick as you'd normally use for Korean short ribs, but that's fine, we're not doing traditional today. English cut, like these, is the other common way you see them in the States, cut along the bone. I'm going to butterfly these to be as thick as the flanken ones, just two cuts to unfold the meat into three flaps. Now for the marinade, lime juice. I did half a dozen, a few garlic cloves, chop them however you want. I just smashed them through the press, and when you do that, you do not have to peel them first, mind you. Onion powder is surprisingly good in marinades, and it sure is easy. Now for the basic combination of cumin followed by dried oregano. That pairing just instantaneously makes things taste like South Florida or Cuba to me. I've got mustard powder here for pungency, but you could do a million things in there. Big pinch of salt, thus converting this marinade into a brininade. And then I'm going to cut it with some water. I usually do at least one part water to two parts citrus for a citrus marinade. Otherwise, the acidity will chemically cook the surface of the meat overnight to the point where the surface will be repulsively mushy. I want to make sure the beef is submerged, so I'll top it off with a little bit more water, cover it up, and marinate it overnight. And here it is the next day. You can see that chemical cooking. Don't worry, it's still red on the inside. It's just the outer layer that's affected, and marinating locks flavor into the outer protein structure, so you can dry it off with paper towels and it'll still taste strongly of the marinade. I'm drying it because I don't want the moisture to interfere with browning. A little olive oil into my widest pan, heat almost all the way high, and in goes the meat. Korean short ribs usually have a lot of sugar in the marinade, and thus you have to cook them pretty gently. Sugar burns like whoa. Since I don't have anything sweet at all in my marinade, I can blast these. Just get a deep brown crust on them all the way over. And while Korean short ribs are generally cooked all the way through, I'm making my own rules today, so I'm going to cook these medium. Short ribs are surprisingly tender when cooked pink. Then, so as to not waste all that beautiful fond, I'll throw in some sliced shallot and a big pile of rainbow chard. Any dark green would be great, just remember it'll wilt down a lot. And I will deglaze with a splash of my leftover marinade. To balance that acidity and the bitterness of the greens, I will summon forth the upside down bear. Nice big squeeze of honey, stir that all up. On the plate with some plain rice, I'll cut the ribs in between the bones, and on they go, nice and pink on the inside. They're still pretty acidic, and I'm gonna miss that sweet glaze you get with the Korean style ribs, so hey, let's summon forth the upside down bear again. Oh, was that a t-shirt? Nice glaze of honey all over this, and we can balance that sweet with a little garnish of fresh red chili, thinly sliced, and hell, a little cilantro on top too. You can knife and fork it, or there's no reason that can't be a finger food. It's amazing how much more steak-like that tastes with a deep brown crust on it. Now, about that shirt. Yes, it is a real t-shirt, and yes, you can buy it, assuming you put in your pre-order within 2 weeks of this video going live. It's a limited printing. The link to my Bonfire store is in the description. The shirt is $20 US plus shipping and tax. It's really high quality. The shirt is super soft. It's screen printed, not laser printed. The design is by the great Andrea Hickey, who has done all of my original graphics. I think she really captured that subtly sinister look that bear-shaped honey dispensers always seem to be giving you. This is my brains. It's unisex. It goes up to 3XL. Lauren's got on an extra small. I've got on a medium. Get your pre-order in within 14 days of this video going live. Then we will print the shirts and send them out, and they should all be delivered between December 8th and 17th, so it can be the perfect gift for your honey bear. Again, link to my Bonfire store is in the description. I appreciate your business. Now give us a squeeze.